Roslyn Kind was barely out of high school when she made her first appearance on The Ed Sullivan Show. But nothing can change the shape of things to come. The teenager had inherited her sensational singing chops from her mum, Diana.
When I used to sing as a kid in the living room in the mirror, my mother would come in at some point and get in front of me in the mirror and take over. So she had the show, you know, she had that in her DNA.
Diana's eldest daughter was also blessed with a pretty special singing voice. In fact, some say the world's greatest. Shadows falling, baby, we stand alone. There are 9 years separating Barbra and her younger sibling.
My sister taught me how to harmonize when I was a kid and singing around the house.
The sisters were raised in the vibrant and ethnically diverse New York borough of Brooklyn.
We had Chinese, Italian, Irish, Jewish. My sister even worked for our neighbors who owned the Chinese restaurant, and I used to go with her to give lollipops out to the kids when they were paying their checks. Don't know
who you are. Roz and Barbra have different dads, but it's hard not to notice the family resemblance. There's the accent, the hair, the polished nails. But that's where Roz says the comparisons end.
What's genes is genes. You can't take that away. That will always be there.
It took several decades for the sisters to finally share a stage. Roz wanted to wait until she'd found her own voice.
Everybody used to ask me, do you want... I said, that is the biggest dream of my life, and I would love it to happen, but I always felt that I had to reach a certain status in my own career on my own before that would happen.
And that's very important.
Yes.
Otherwise, your identity gets lost.
Exactly. This is my big shift. She brought me out and we did the duet. Nervous, but when I walked out to the applause of the audience and yet them yelling out, Roslyn, it really felt so good, and I just started to wave and smile and say hi. How much do I love you? I felt wonderful, and my nephew was going to be on there too. So we traveled as a family, we worked as a family, we ate out, we went shopping. It was a great time.
Like her sister, Roz made the leap to film and to television.
Barbara's sister, close enough, same DNA.
I remember seeing you on The Nanny.
I had a great time doing it.
How could you not with that wonderful cast?
No, they were great. They were wonderful. And Renee and...
She's even shared the screen with Barbra. The main event with Ryan O'Neill, you were there.
Yes, I was one of the exercise people in Gilda's exercise class.
Wow.
Esther Hoffman.
A Star is Born, the wonderful version with your sister and Kris Kristofferson.
I was at the award show. Actually, I read for Diane Crittenden several times for different parts. She read me 8 different ways. Well, I was up for the role of the druggie that was in the car with her. Oh, I could do you too. But she said, you know what? You're just too similar to have you in that scene together.
It's true.
So I didn't get that role, but I ended up, you know, as a party at her table.
Yes.
At the award show.
Roz has 4 hit albums under her belt and is currently putting the finishing touches to her latest. Come on, people.
Come on, children. This is such a project of the heart. One of the songs I wrote, as a matter of fact, it was the one that was on The Nanny. So we have an incredible arrangement of that getting ready to come out. But the one that's out now, the Laura Nero cover, and it's called Save the Country. Save the oceans, save the rivers,
save the forests. Like her sister's 2018 album, Walls, Roz doesn't shy away from being political in song.
So proud of this work, but mostly what I'm proud of is the message. I want people to come together. I don't want people to be divided and separated. I want people to have. Nobody should be overlooked in this world. There's plenty for everybody, and the people in the power position should be helping take care of that. There is no life, I know,
to compare with pure imagination. Has it been difficult for you to find your own voice amid the comparisons?
In the beginning,
but
yes.
Not it was now?
No, I have my own following now, and I've stretched my talents out. I've gone in different areas. I found my funny along the way. I'm a different performer. I perform differently than my sister. So I know that there's differences, and I think the audiences are realizing it now, too. So I'm very happy about that. But only we can live.